In this video, I talk to absolute legend RJ Mical. He's currently the director of gaming at Google, but we met up at Amiga 30 in Amsterdam. So we're going to be talking about Amiga pioneering years, Amiga culture, the Lynx, Atari, Google, and the future of gaming, really. Now, I had a few issues with the audio in this, so I have added subtitles. Sit back, relax, and enjoy the video.
I saw a few clips. feel about it, that, yeah, there seems to be a revival going on, and I've reached Dream Mine and the Light of Mine. I don't know that we could do anything with the original Amiga anymore. That spirit, that drive, that vision, you could still create something new and different in the market.
You kind of feel like the Amiga and Commodore have kind of been forgotten by mainstream media? You know, kind of they talk about Microsoft and Apple all the time, don't they? Like, you never seem to get much coverage of it by, like, you know, say you watch a documentary about computers on the BBC or HBO, they never mention Commodore and the Amiga, do they much?
They never mention the Commodore and the Amiga unless it's a history show where they're looking back in time. And I don't feel any animosity or any bad feelings about it at all, because it's just numbers, you know. There's 18 bazillion of those and 4 million of this. No one.
The thing is, as well, it's still probably like people find their eyes that are out. It's like, you know, I'm done. It's in here, but it's in. They're like 95. You know, like, how is that possible? Where's the time diagram? And I was like, yeah, it's all in real time. You know?
And everyone's caught up now. You know, a video editing on a person's computer is normal these days. Multitasking, that's normal, everybody expects what we did at first, you know? And I just am so still
astounded.
Some of them did, and you know, the believers did. There was a lot of people that really jumped out of the bandwagon earlier and talked about how powerful the system was and all that you could do with it. But, you know, it didn't get popular with the public because it just didn't get the exposure that it needed.
Basically, us, Victorian tests.
Yes, except I don't like the term. one real key reason. The Turing test is designed to fool humans. It's to get us to gauge whether or not this particular conversation was intelligent and how intelligent.
Yeah,
it's like this black and white thing. You're in or you're out. You succeeded or you failed. And so to succeed, you don't. No one's like motivated to create real dialogue. They're just motivated to find ways to trick a human. Unbelievable.
Yeah.
back then, no one was recording videos and putting them on YouTube, so I tell the story again and again and again to a new audience, and it was just all so much fun. But finally now, someone's captured it.